Well, Tanya and Steve, parents weren't especially surprised to hear about the cancellation of classes tomorrow. They expected a strike given all the rhetoric. So at this hour tomorrow, there will be alternative staffing here at Skinner West and all CPS campuses. The 360,000 kids in the nation's third largest school district reported for classes this morning, unaware of when the next regular school day might be. Many CPS parents are hoping employers will be understanding.
They'll have to be, because my kid comes first.
I'm gonna have to take off. Affects my pay, everything, my life, everything.
For as long as necessary, the district plans to have principals and non-union staff on hand during normal school hours at all CPS buildings, along with regular food service. Activities will be offered, but there will be no coursework with teachers on strike. Many families plan to assess day by day.
In the morning, trying to find a babysitter and everything is going to be a little bit tough, but we're going to hopefully manage.
An array of contingency options are also being offered by the city and community organizations. The alternatives include public libraries, YMCA locations, neighborhood community centers, and many churches. Amid the planning, our parents who are frustrated it has come to this, the cancellation of classes and a strike while negotiations are still ongoing.
To try some other means, and striking should be the last resort. But I don't think they're really negotiating in good faith.
Now, with a possible park district strike as well, classes and programming will not be offered by that department as it was in 2012 during the last teacher strike. You may recall that strike lasted 7 days, the longest ever Chicago teacher strike was in 1987, and it went on for 19 days. We're live in the West Loop. Nancy Liu, WGN News.
And